वेलकम बैक एवरीवन. वी स्टार्ट विद द न्यू टॉपिक मैटरनल एंड चाइल्ड हेल्थ. सो व्हाट इज मैटरनल एंड चाइल्ड हेल्थ केयर? इट रेफर्स टू अ पैकेज ऑफ कॉम्प्रहेंसिव हेल्थ केयर सर्विसेज विच आर डेवलप्ड टू मीट प्रमोटिव प्रिवेंटिव क्यूरेटिव एंड रिहैबिलिटेटिव नीड्स ऑफ प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन बिफोर ड्यूरिंग एंड आफ्टर डिलीवरी एंड ऑफ इन्फेंट्स एंड प्री स्कूल चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम बर्थ टू 5 years. सो मैटरनल एंड चाइल्ड हेल्थ केयर मीन्स इट्स एवरीथिंग. Every care of a pregnant woman, that is including promotive, preventive, curative and rehabilitative care in every period from the starting or the before, during and after the delivery of a infant. And then it includes infant also and preschool children also from birth to 5 years. So for these people, if you are giving care, then it is called maternal and child health care, MCH care. So what is the objective? To reduce maternal mortality and morbidity, decreasing the death rate and the disability rate, reduce perinatal and neonatal mortality and morbidity. Here, reducing the morbidity, that is disease rate and mortality death rate of a natal and neonatal babies, regulate fertility so as to have wanted and healthy children when desired. Fertility of a person to be increased by various methods, that is nutrition or exercise, anything, natural method, so that they will have the healthy children. Provide basic maternal and child health care to all mothers and children. Basic care to be given to all the mothers and children. And promote and protect health of mother. Promote and protect physical growth and psychosocial development of children. Complete welfare and development of children to be taken care here, including promoting protection of physical growth and psychosocial development. What are the components of MCH care? It includes maternal health, child health and family planning. First is about maternal health care. It is caring of a pregnant woman, childbirth and after childbirth. Okay, during childbirth, sorry, before, during and after the childbirth. It also includes treatment of childless couple. Okay, even the childless couples will get this care for development of fertility. Okay. Maternal risk factors. It is defined as the probability of a dying or experiencing serious injury as a result of pregnancy or childbirth. What is the maternal risk factor means? She will get the condition which is very serious because of the pregnancy. So that is the main risk. First is about young primee, that is the mother below 19 years. So she will be having the great risk to both mother and the child because the teenager mother. She is still growing and is not adequately equipped to cope the pregnancy and labor and is not psychologically prepared for the responsibility of marriage. So physically and psychologically, she is not prepared, so it is very difficult for her to manage the pregnancy. And elderly primee, that is after the 30 years and over, having babies too late in life leads to increased risk of complication in pregnancy and labor. Yes. There will be more risk factors, the risk because of the late marriage and late pregnancy. Having too many babies, this is also a risk. When the mother bears more than 3 babies, she is at high risk of developing problems due to repeated pregnancies and labor. This is due to weakening of tissues, depletion of nutrition, and overall poor physical health of the mother. If the mother is having more pregnancies or more babies, then her physical, psychological, every health will be deteriorated. Next, having two close pregnancies. When the interval between the two pregnancies is less than 3 years, it can create problems during the pregnancy. It's because mother did not get enough time to recover completely and fully from the stress and strain of the previous pregnancy. Okay? During the delivery or the during pregnancy, the complete changes of the body occurs. Even the uterus, there be changes, and there is a band in the uterus, midway of the uterus. When the delivery happens or the pregnancy time, it will be expanding. Okay? And it takes time to cure or come back to the normal period. It takes around 2 to 3 years. In between, again, if they have the baby, there will be structural damage to that band. So that's why it is very dangerous to have pregnancy very close. So what are the other conditions of mother? Mother with short height, that is less than 145 centimeter, having a small and inadequate pelvis, so that she is not adequate to have the baby in her uterus. Okay, she cannot go for normal delivery also. Mothers having less than 40 kg of weight, usually underweight mothers are malnourished and anemic and have high risk of developing complication pregnancy. Okay, because of malnourishment and anemia, she will undergo again more risk if she become a pregnant. So it's a dangerous sign. Mothers having more than 70 kg of weight have difficulty during the childbirth. Mothers having malnutrition and anemia, these mothers are weak and find it difficult to tolerate the stress and strain of pregnancy and childbirth. Even here, malnutrition and anemia causes the greater risk to the mother. So what are the associated medical conditions which is very risky? The mother having the heart disease, high blood pressure, kidney disease, tuberculosis, diabetes, repeated attack of malaria, hepatic disorder, etc. If the mother is having this condition, she should not undergo pregnancy. After treatment, she can have. So what component you have seen? Antenatal. The maternal health care components are antenatal care, natal care and postnatal care. So what are the antenatal care? The objectives are to promote, protect and maintain health of mother during pregnancy, to ensure the birth of mature and healthy baby, to identify high-risk mother and give them appropriate and attention to prevent complication. High-risk mother means the whatever disease we have seen, whatever the risk we have seen, that's called high-risk mother. And we have to prevent the complication. To prepare the mother for confinement, to prepare the mother to care for her baby. Okay, she should be ready for the delivery and caring the baby. That is the antenatal care. The services under the antenatal care are registration of pregnant women. So here the mother must be registered within 12 weeks of pregnancy. Antenatal visit, ideally the mother should attend the antenatal clinic once a month during the first 7 months, twice a month during the second month, and thereafter once a week if everything is normal. Otherwise she should visit again and again. First you will visit the first 7 months, once a month you will go, then next twice a month you will go during the second period, then afterwards you will go every week. Care during first contact, taking health history, physical examination, general medical examination, obstetrical examination, laboratory examination. Obstetric examination means regarding the pregnancy, some examination will be done. What are the immunizations are taken? It is 2 doses of tetanus toxin, that is first dose at 16 to 20 weeks and second dose at 20 to 24 weeks of pregnancy. And the tablet is iron and folic acid tablet, that is twice a day for at least 100 days. And health education, it's about diet. Okay? A well-balanced diet is required during pregnancy for the proper growth of development of fetus and for optimum health of mother. A pregnant woman should be educated regarding the personal hygiene. She should maintain the proper personal hygiene. Smoking and drinking. Mother should be advised to avoid smoking and drinking alcohol. It leads to low birth weight and retardation. And the drugs. The mother should be advised not to take any medicines unless it is prescribed by the doctor. And radiation, the mother should be advised to avoid abdominal x-ray. It predisposes child to risk of leukemia and other cancers. Okay? If the mother undergoes x-ray or if she come in contact with any kind of radiation, it is affecting the baby. Okay? There will be a risk of leukemia and other cancers. Protection from infections and illness. An expectant mother should be instructed to protect herself from the risk of infection, especially measles, syphilis, because this infection can cause spontaneous abortion,
malformation, mental retardation, and stillbirth, etc. Okay? If the mother is having this disease, mesencephalus, the child may have, after the birth, the child may have malformation, mental retardation, and stillbirth, or sometimes there will be spontaneous abortion. That is, abortion. Okay? Immediate abortion. And sexual activities, ovoid coitus during the first and last trimester. First trimester, it increases the risk of abortion, and last trimester, it predisposes the infection. So, avoid the coitus during the first and second trimester. Sorry, last trimester. And travel, avoid travel during the first and the last trimester.
Reporting of untoward sign and symptom. The mother should be instructed to report to health person if there is any unusual pain, bleeding from vagina, swelling in the feet, hand or face, headache, blurred vision, dizziness, high fever, baby's movement not being felt. This every signs and symptoms are very important, and it is must be informed to the doctor and health checkup to be done. And child care, the mother should be educated on various aspects of child care. And follow-up visits, mother must be educated about the need for regular visits and proper care during the pregnancy. Preparing for confinement. The preparation for safe delivery is very important. It should be done well in advance to avoid any type of difficulty or emergency which might occur at the time of delivery. So, we should set the hospital before itself. We should inform them that you are coming. Then all the registration must be done. Reservation also must be done here before the time. Psychological preparation of the mother. The expectant mother, especially the primary para, that is first pregnancy, mother has fear and anxiety about childbirth, its outcome and complication, etc. It is very important to discuss various aspects of pregnancy and delivery. This helps in overcoming their fears and anxiety. So, the mother, first pregnancy mother, will be having some anxiety and fear. So, we should give health care to that mother, and we should motivate so that she will, her anxiety will reduce. Okay, and she will be prepared, psychologically prepared for the pregnancy and delivery. Family planning. When the mother is pregnant, she is more receptive because she is experiencing the impact and burden of childbirth. The mother should be educated and motivated for small family norm and spaces of children. So, during the childbirth, she will be having certain problem, and there will be more chance of reception, okay? Because she is experiencing the impact and burden of childbirth. So, she should be educated and motivated for small family norm. Small family norm is girl or boy, any child is okay. And the second child is after the 3 years with complete universal immunization. That is a small family norm. And she should adopt that. And spacing of children is, that is 3 years gap between the child. This, about this, we should inform the mother. And natal care, it's during the delivery, okay? In the confinement, the care is given. So what's the objective? To prevent infection, prevent injury to both mother and baby, to detect and deal with any complication, example, antipara and postpara hemorrhage, prolonged labor, malpresentation, prolapse cord, etc. Okay. To see this complication, we should go for a natal care, that is during the childbirth. To resuscitate the baby and to provide immediate care to the baby. What is the care after the natal or after delivery? Preparing of place and surrounding of confinement. Okay, the ward or the room should be prepared. Preparation of equipment and supplies required during the delivery. So during delivery, whatever preparation you needed for the equipment and supply, everything to be done. Physical and psychological preparation for mother to be done. Examination of mother's physical condition, abdominal palpation, monitoring fetal sound, observation of vital signs, labor pain, uterine extraction. This everything to be done during the natal, that is during the delivery. Conducting delivery, watchful about any problem and helping mother in taking pains. Referral of mother immediately in case of any such problem. If any problem occurs, immediate referral should be done to the senior doctor and can be shifted to any superior ward and hospital.
giving immediate care to mother and baby after delivery, giving instruction to the mother and family members, maintaining the recording and reporting of birth to authority. Recording and reporting should be done soon after the birth, that is documentation, the time, date, everything to be done. So what are the postnatal care? The objective is, or the what is postnatal care? That is giving the care or referring the care to render to both mother and baby after the delivery. So what objective? To restore, promote and maintain health of mother and baby. So there is a lot of changes occurred in the pregnancy, so we have to restore it. Promote breastfeeding, to prevent complication, any complication occurs after the delivery, that should be prevented. To establish good nutrition of the baby, to prevent infection and identify any health problem, disorder in the baby. Infection to be prevented and any disorder occurs or present, we should notice that. To support and strengthen the parents' confidence and their role within their family and cultural environment. Okay. And to motivate for planned and small family now, to educate mother and family on various aspects of mother and child care. First, the last thing is health education of the mother and the family regarding the mother and child care. So what are the immediate care of the newborn? First, you should clear the airway for the easy breathing and the cry of the baby. Then maintenance of body temperature of a baby is very important and it should be cleaned first, little clean should be the done, okay. Then immediately you should cover it with a clean cloth or wrap it with a clean cloth and kept close to the mother for the skin to skin contact. And within half an hour, breastfeeding should be started, within 1 hour, okay. Care of the eyes, that is from the inside to outside or inner canthus to outer canthus, with a cool swab or a boiled cooled swab, we should rub that or wipe that, okay. Once if you use the cotton, same swab you cannot use to the another eye. Care of umbilical cord, it is ligated, that is, it is cut for the 6 to 9 centimeter gap from the umbilicus and it is cut with a sterilized scissor. It should be kept for the dry. We should see if any infection is there. Color should be noticed every day, any infection, everything. And special instruction to given to the mother and family not to apply anything like oil, ash, cow dung or anything. Okay. And Apgar scoring, soon after the birth, within 1 minute and 5 minutes, we should check the Apgar. Okay. That is heart rate, respiration, muscle tone, reflex and the color to be checked first time, 5th minute. And care of the skin, it's very important to keep the baby clean and warm. And the vernix of the baby is a protective nature, that is whitish, creamish color present on the baby's skin. So it is acceptable and after the 12 to 24 hours, it can be bathed. The baby can be bathed. Okay. And the physical examination of the baby is needed. If any injury happened during the birth or any malformation or any changes in the health condition to be noted. And breastfeeding soon after 1 hour after birth or half an hour after birth. And what are the immediate care of the mother? So after the baby is born, the placenta is delivered. Whatever placenta is kept inside or present inside, it is to be delivered and kept in a tray and examined it. The fundus is palpated and clots are expressed and the fundal height is measured. Okay. Soon after the birth, and everything, the whatever fundus is inside fundus, everything to be removed and our fundal height should be checked. The perineum is inspected for any laceration or tear. Perineal care is given and napkin is fixed. This is very important in the OBG. And mother is made comfortable by removing the soiled linen through the cleaning and by keeping her warm and etc. So
it is wet because of blood and she will be very dirty. So everything should be cleaned and she should be kept in the clean linen. Hot drink is given, thereafter the vital signs are recorded. So what are the instructions you will give to the mother and family? Regarding mother, the rest to be given. If bleeding is there, you should watch for that. Perineal hygiene to be maintained and normal diet to be maintained. And if any cases or if any problem occurs, it should be reported to the doctor. And regarding baby, bleeding should be checked if the cord is having any bleeding or infection to be checked. Breastfeeding of the child to be done. And the baby should not get any water. We should not give any water or anything, and we should not apply anything on the cord, okay? Umbilical cord. And postnatal visit, it is very important to give regular and frequent visit to postnatal mother when the delivery is conducted in home. Okay, if the mother is delivered at the home, then we should visit, the nurses should visit. That is first visit within 24 hours of the delivery, okay? And second visit 5th or 6th day, third visit 10th day, fourth visit second to fourth week, fifth visit 6th to 8th week. So certain visit can be done in the clinic also. So during this visit, both mother and baby are given care to meet their health needs. And care of the mother, the cleanliness should be maintained, temperature, pulse, and respiration should be checked, examination of the breast, and whether involution of uterus has occurred, that is returning of the uterus to the normal stage, and lochia, that is discharge from the vagina, and perineum also to be checked for any abnormalities. And abdomen signs also we should check, and pain, whether it is pain or hard, to be checked. It should be seen that the mother takes adequate nutrition diet, takes sufficient rest and sleep, keeps herself clean and protect from infection, and breastfeeds her baby. And care of the newborn, whatever we have seen already, the temperature, heart rate, any abnormalities there we should check, eyes discharge if anything, skin color, cord stem, and weight, or any abnormalities in the body, everything to be checked. It should be seen that the baby is adequately clothed and kept clean, breastfed on demand, allowed to sleep and rest most of the time, and handled only when necessary. Not to give bottle feed. Okay, mother should be inquired about any problem regarding the baby. And child health care. What is child health care? The child health care refers to the care of children from conception to birth till the age of 5. So objective C, every child receives adequate care and a proper nourishment. Every child is immunized and protected from the disease. To monitor growth and development, to identify ailment and treat it without delay, to educate the mother and family members to give proper care to the children. The main objective is immunization, growth and development check or monitoring. If any ailment is there, that should be checked. Ailment means any diseases, and the education to be given to the family members. Care of child, that is personal care. If any hygiene problem, we should give education regarding that, personal hygiene. And if any injury is there, that also to be checked and the treatment is given. And again, we can examine regarding the body temperature, rest and sleep, exercise, training of child regarding health habits can be done. Feeding the baby, first you will give 6 months only breastfeeding. Okay. Then after 6 months, you can give the supplementary food. Okay. Some mashed food, smashed food, that you can give it after the 6 months. Monitoring of growth and development to be done, that is health and nutrition status of the baby can be done. And any normal, if the baby is normal or if any deviation occurred or weight and height, weight changes, and everything to be recorded in a month up to 1 year, once in 2 months up to 2 years, and once in 3 months up to 5 years. Okay, every month in the first year, 2 months, once in a 2 months in second year, up to second year, and till 5 years, every 3 months you should check. And the immunization of the baby to be done, that is including the tuberculosis, tetanus, diphtheria, whooping cough, measles and poliomyelitis. For everything we should give the immunization, and the reaction if anything is there we should notify it, and it should be explained what immunization is taken and the schedule to the family. Safety and security of the children to be noted, like water, milk and food to be free from the infections or toxins. Disease carrying insect must be controlled, and accident and hazard need to be removed or controlled in order to prevent accidents such as fall, burn, poisoning, drowning, aspiration of foreign object, cuts and abrasion. So this can be done by removing the accidental hazards. Early recognition and treatment of ailment such as diarrheal disease, acute respiratory infection, vaccine preventable disease, nutritional deficiency problem. So this everything we should be noted before itself, and we can treat those things to reduce the morbidity and mortality. And the packages, what are the packages that are available? First, TT immunization, prevention and treatment of anemia, antenatal care and early detection of identification of maternal complication, delivery by trained personnel, promotion of institutional deliveries, management of obstructive emergencies and birth spacing. So these are the packages available under the MCH care. And for the, that's for the mother, and for the children, essential newborn care, exclusive breastfeeding and weaning, immunization, appropriate management of diarrhea, appropriate management of acute respiratory infection, vitamin A prophylaxis and treatment of anemia. So these are the packages available under the MCH for the children. And for the eligible couple, prevention of pregnancy and safe abortion. That's the package available for eligible couple. So under reproductive tract infection and sexually transmitted infection, prevention and treatment of this to be done. How can we deliver this MCH service? First is through the village health guide or village health post. Here trained dais and the guides will be there. And primary health care is given by the village health guide. She will be trained in the 3 months to render the simple mother and child and family planning services. The dais are trained for 1 month to provide safe hygienical services during the antenatal, natal and postnatal period. They can also provide family planning services. So here dais and village health guides will give the care in the rural area or village health. At sub-center level, multi-purpose health worker will be there, even male or female. The function carried out, contacting eligible couple and motivating for small family norm, registration of all pregnant women, providing essential antenatal and postnatal care, immunization of mother and children, nutrition and health education, ensure safe delivery through trained birth attendant, that is hospital delivery. And in the primary health center, it rendered all those services which are rendered from the sub-center. So whatever the services we are giving in the sub-center, same services, but in the good manner. And the planning, organizing and implementing MCH program and services are done in the PHCs, primary health care. Coordinating the work of all sub-center, they will act as a supervisor. Collecting and compiling performance reports of MCH activities from sub-center to be done. Ensuring inter-sector coordination, that is between the sub-center, village sector and the primary health care, primary health center, all inter-sector coordination to be done. And training and continuing education program of maternal and child health teams. Community health center, the center is manned by 4 specialists and 21 health personnel, including 7 nurse midwives and other staff. It serves first referral unit and provides specialist service for the mother and children. So it is the higher authority of PHCs, and there 21 health personnel will be there with the 4 specialists. And in the urban area, the services can be available through district family welfare units or centers, district and state level hospital, urban MCH center, clinics and maternity homes and hospitals, urban family welfare centers, and the NGO will give MCH care through nursing homes and hospitals, voluntary organization and charitable trusts, private practitioners of all systems. So that's what about the maternal and child health care and the family planning. We'll see in the next class. Thank you.